Hello and welcome to Unit 4. This is the first of several units on power laws. In this unit, I'll say what power laws are, we'll explore some of their mathematical properties, and see how they're related to fractals and self-similarity. In the next unit, we'll look at some examples of power laws and talk about how to work with power law data. In Unit 6, we'll look at some of the many different mechanisms that can generate power laws. So we've actually already encountered power laws. In the previous unit, that equation we worked with again and again and again for the box counting dimension, well, that's a power law. And we saw that when that equation is true, when that equation is obeyed over a range of scales S, that we're dealing with a fractal. There's some sort of self-similarity. And so what we're going to see in this unit and the next several is that there are other situations that are described by a similar equation, not necessarily box counting, it might be something else. But when we see an equation like that, that's an indication that there's some sort of scale-free behavior. So we'll begin this unit by looking at an initial example of a power law, so I have something concrete to talk about. And then in the rest of this unit, I'll talk about a number of the mathematical properties and interesting and important features of power laws. And I'll also talk about some things that aren't power laws and contrast power law behavior with normal or Gaussian behavior. And so we'll talk about the central limit theorem. So let's get started in the next video with an initial example.